Hello friends, welcome to Acknowledge India YouTube channel. This is Manoj Deva. Today I am going to explain about Press Information Bureau current affairs. This is useful for UPSC and Group 1 and Group 2 and other competitive examinations. Today I am going to explain about 5th to 12th, 1 week's current affairs related to PIB. So it's from 5th to 12th July 2017. Let's move on to the first topic. President of India attend the launch of Swayamprabha and National Academic Depository. So I am already explained this video. You can watch it from our previous videos. So let's move on to the next topic. Union Ministry reviews the program of two flagship schemes. Those are National Agricultural Markets, we call it as ENAMS, and Soil Health Card. So National Agricultural Markets, it's a pan-India electronic trading portal which networks the existing APMC mandis to create a unified national market for agricultural commodities, and it provides a single window service for all APMC related information and service. This includes commodity arrivals and prices, buy and sell trade offers, provisions to respond to traders' offers, among the services. So this is about National Agricultural Markets. And about Soil Health Card, Soil Health Card management aims at promoting integrated nutrient-rich management through judicious use of chemical fertilizers, including secondary micronutrients in conjugation with organic manures and biofertilizers, improving soil health and its productivity. The strengthening of soil and fertilizer testing and facilitate to provide soil test based recommendations to the farmers for improving soil fertility. So Beijing Declaration on Education, adopted in 5th meeting of BRICS Ministers of Education in Beijing, China on July 5th, 2017. The Beijing Declaration on Education's major objectives are BRICS Network University and increasing cultural cooperation among BRICS nations, and promoting professionalization of academics in higher education, and improving teacher quality and performance, and strengthening cooperation in the field of technical and vocational education training. BRICS Think Tanks Council, they are going to set up BRICS Think Tanks Council, and the importance of streamlining the cooperation among the educational think tanks and education researchers. And also youth winter summer camps, means a student, some kind of student exchange programs. And also expanding the number of scholarships, and also share the experience and participate in achieving the SDG for Education 2013 targets in order to foster a more favorable policy environment. And also, and last final thing, encourage the participation in 3rd BRICS Network University annual conference to be held in 2018 Cape Town, South Africa. So next meeting will be in South Africa, Cape Town. So these are the Beijing Declaration on Education among BRICS nations. Next news is that Jignasa, the student scientist connect program launched by the government. The Council of Scientific and Industrial Research, that means CSIR, has joined hand with the Kendriya Vidyalayas to implement this program. The focus is on connecting school students and scientists so as they extend students' classroom learning with that of a very well-planned research laboratory-based learning. This model engagement includes student residential programs and scientists as teachers and teachers as scientists, lab-specific activities, and visit of scientists to the schools, and science math clubs, and popular lecture series, and student apprenticeship program, and science exhibitions, and projects of National Children's Science Congress, teacher workshop and tinkering laboratories. These are the major things included in this program. This is very important. Why? Because recently there is a news about an Indian boy who has developed the world's smallest satellite for NASA. The boy's name is Rifat Shahrukh. He developed a satellite name called KalamSat. So he developed for NASA. So like this, we can encourage scientific temper among the students. Historic city of Ahmedabad is UNESCO's World Heritage property now. The walled city of Ahmedabad, the first city in India and the third city in Asia to be inscribed to the World Heritage list. India now has overall 36 World Heritage inscriptions with 28 cultural, 7 natural and 1 mixed site. While India stands second largest in number after China in terms of number of World Heritage properties in Asia-Pacific region, it is overall 7th in the world. And also Ahmedabad is on eastern bank of Sabarmati River. Please remember, a rich architectural heritage. It is a unique example of multi-religious and multicultural coexistence. So when you are preparing for civil services, just read related things and background of Ahmedabad. Approval for upgradation and widening of Imphal Moray section of NH-39 in Manipur. Actually Manipur is a landlocked place and Moray is the place where we have a border with Myanmar. So the cooperation road connectivity investment program, which aims at upgradation of roads infrastructure in Bangladesh, Bhutan, Nepal and India in order to improve the regional connectivity among BBIN nations. The project corridor is also a part of Asian Highway number 1, means which connect India with Myanmar and Thailand and act as India's gateway to the east. Thus trade and commerce and tourism in this region will get boost with this project. It will fulfill the Look East policy and to promote enhance the trade link with the South Asian nations. Anyhow, thank you for visiting our channel. For more updates, please subscribe Acknowledge India YouTube channel. If you want any kind of help, please feel free to contact us acknowledgeindia@gmail.com. This is your Manoj Deva signing off.